Let's learn about cardiac output and the Frank-Starling Law of the heart. Cardiac output is the amount of blood pumped through one of the ventricles of the heart in 1 minute. Cardiac output is equal to the stroke volume times the heart rate. The stroke volume is the amount of blood in one ventricle. For example, the stroke volume of the left ventricle is about 70 milliliters, and an average heart rate is about 75 beats per minute. If we multiply the two numbers together, we get a cardiac output of 5,250 milliliters per minute, or 5.25 liters per minute. This means that 5.25 liters of blood moves through the left ventricle every minute. The stroke volume is equal to the end diastolic volume minus the end systolic volume. The end diastolic volume is the amount of blood in the ventricle after diastole. That is, the amount of blood in the ventricle after it fills while it is relaxed. The end systolic volume is the amount of blood remaining in the ventricle after systole, which is the amount of blood remaining in the ventricle after it contracts. The end diastolic volume is about 120 milliliters, and the end systolic volume is about 50 milliliters. If we subtract the two numbers, we get our stroke volume of 70 milliliters. The Frank-Starling law of the heart has an effect on stroke volume. Preload has an effect on the Frank-Starling law. Preload is the amount cardiac muscle is stretched before contraction. Preload depends on venous return. Here's an example. Exercise brings more blood to the heart. We say that exercise increases venous return. The more blood flowing into the heart causes the cardiac muscle to stretch more. The muscle responds by contracting more forcefully. This is the Frank-Starling law. In other words, the more that cardiac muscle is stretched, the stronger it contracts, at least to a point. The muscle contracts more forcefully because the number of actin and myosin cross bridges increases. When cardiac muscle contracts harder, stroke volume increases, and so does cardiac output. Likewise, at rest, low venous return decreases stroke volume and cardiac output. The heart contracts less forcefully due to the Frank-Starling law. Contractility also affects stroke volume. Contractility is the strength of contraction at a given muscle length. Contractility depends on calcium influx into cardiac muscle. It does not depend on load, but does depend on calcium influx into the muscle cells. The more calcium that enters the cells, the more forcefully the muscle contracts. Here's an illustration. The more calcium that enters the cardiac muscle cells, the stronger the contraction. The sympathetic nervous system increases calcium influx, which increases contractility, which in turn increases stroke volume. Afterload also affects stroke volume. Afterload is the pressure against the pulmonary and aortic valves the heart must push against in order to move the blood. Hypertension, or high blood pressure, can increase afterload and decrease stroke volume by decreasing end-systolic volume. The autonomic nervous system affects the heart rate. Mary the marathoner has a low resting heart rate because she has increased her stroke volume through exercise. Her cardiovascular system easily maintains cardiac output by compensating for the increased stroke volume by decreasing her heart rate. Cedric, the congestive heart failure patient, has a high resting heart rate because his stroke volume has decreased due to disease. his cardiovascular system struggles to maintain cardiac output by increasing his heart rate. We hope you have learned something about cardiac output, and see you next time.